I am back again. There was a technological disruption, so that was the reason we are not interacting with you. But again, I am back with my remaining thought. So we were talking about emerging opportunities in business. We were talking about how the technological change is bringing change in the organization, bringing change in business, and there were certain ingredients which are going to play a very important role. And these ingredients are nothing but the counterparts who are associated with the. With the company as a employee, as a consumers, and consumers' role is quite utmost in nature, because the consumers' power of consumer is not merely to navigate company to go for the implementation of technology, but it takes into consideration many things like digital integration. When we talk about the digital integration, there also the consumer's role is very important. And we have seen that rather mouth marketing was a term which was used in business long back, where consumers use the product and then it refers the product to the other consumers. So the same model it is applying in this technological business era also. And we have seen that. Consumers are giving their reviews online on the e-commerce portals, and through that e-commerce portals, other consumers can go through their thought and know the opinion about the product, and then they buy the product. So this is something where dynamic marketplace matters, and consumers not only navigate, not only reframe the companies, but sometimes suggest that if you are not going to change yourself, you can switch over to other brands. So this is the trend which is going on, and those companies who have adapted the change, who had taken the opinion about the consumers and emphasize more on sales services, providing better services to the consumers, they stand in the market and rest go on. So we have seen that it's not like that the company which started with a different framework when enters into the market and come up with a multiple approach. So like the example of Google is there. Google was purely a search engine, but right now then they have provided the email applications, and right now they have given many things. They have given the Google Drive, the virtual drive. So this concept of keeping the data on the desktop, on the laptops, on the home servers, it had gone. We put the data on the clouds, and this cloud computing is nothing but a different approach. So on the other hand, they have created their own application also. So rather than using the Microsoft Office, we have switched over into the Open Office or the Google Office. So where no need to carry many things. So the data is now on the cloud, and the consumers or the users can go through it. So this had bring a new change to the learning, and by that the things had been changed. So what we have observed that this employee is the next thing which is there, and successful employees meet deadlines and make sales and build the sales, and they are very loyal to their company, and from there the things are going to be changed. So on the other hand, we have observed that a lot of change is coming up, and this is going to bring the new approaches to the other things. So now the next thing which is more important, that how the trends affecting global business management. So there are certain trends which are affecting the global business, and when you talk the global business, you have to talk about the scenario which is changing, and this scenario brings a lot of change in the organization. So emerging markets are there, lot of markets which are emerging on day-to-day basis, and the trend which is changing. So keeping in mind the data analytics approach had come up. So when you talk about the industry leaders, you have seen that they analyze the data. So what I have talked about in the beginning stage, that data analytics is nothing but the real time data. So there was a time when data was purely a name, email and mobile, but right now this had been changed. So data analytics is exactly providing the real time information about the consumer, that what exactly the consumer think about the product. So consumers have instant access to product information. That is more important. Like if I want to buy any product and I just want to know the reviews, I just want to know the approach of the product, the functioning of the product, like how the products performs, and whether I can go for this company product or the different company product. So there, you know, this thing is going to help. So there are certain trends which are affecting. Now the other thing is that the business trends that will impact growth. There are certain business trends which are right now impacting, and AI is one of that. Artificial intelligence is a humanless approach where it can judge the individual opinion and then give the product accordingly. So when I am searching too many products, with the help of AI, the e-commerce portal is able to know this particular product, you know, comes under the ambit of this particular consumers, and then they go for this kind of product or provide the information related to that kind of product. Now there is an increased availability of big data. Big data analytics is something which is there, where you have got a gigantic data and huge bank of the consumers. So how you are going to facilitate the consumer so that they can particularly go for this kind of product. So AI, artificial intelligence, and expansion, and this, it's not like that when you talk about buying or selling the product is the only job of the companies. They are now educating customers, they are now navigating customers, that they can you know, go through or see the product as per their need. So we have seen that there are intelligent enterprises which are more consumer friendly and navigating consumers with the help of technology. So change is also coming up, and there are certain emerging technologies which are there. Blockchain is one of the technology which was coined to streamline the Bitcoins. But after certain time, we have observed that you name the segment, you name the area, the blockchain is there. Either you talk about, you know, the service industry, or you talk about banking industry, or you talk about the hotel industry, it is there. And we more are using, you know, the WhatsApp and this Google Drive. It is nothing but in the backdrop, you will find out that blockchain technology is there. So Satoshi Nakamoto, who was a Japanese, who had created this philosophy just to regulate the Bitcoins, which is known as the virtual currency. And in the coming future, I was talking about, you know, the plastic money, the wallets, but the trend is going to be changed. So in the coming years, you will find out this virtual currency is going to knock a door. So virtual currency is one step ahead to wallets, and you don't carry a currency, and that currency is going to be a legal tender in the coming years. So the moment it becomes a legal tender and worldwide acceptability, the majority of people can do or business with the help of that. So this is the thing which is there, and if you see this particular theme which we were talking about, that is emerging technology business, it is part of our BCOC 132 course, and it's in the first block, and we have got total 20 chapters in this whole course, which I am coordinating as a course coordinator, and you will find out that the fourth unit talks about the emerging opportunities in business. So when you talk about the emerging opportunities in business, the first thing which was there, that is internet application in business. We have seen that Internet of Thing is there, and this IT is no doubt working as a feather in the cap, and we have seen that this business is going to be more acute with the more equipped and more reached to the unreached when there is an internet with them. So with the help of internet, they are not only, you know, navigating the consumers or selling the or to the product to the consumers, but somewhere they are helping the consumers. Yes, emerging opportunities in business. So when you talk about this thing that emerging, there are certain emerging trends I have already talked about. Impact of technology in business is changing with the change of time, and this technology is the definition of technology is changing. There was a time 2-3 decades back when computer was there, and the computer was a hot cake. But then computer was replaced by smartphones, the gadgets, and right now the other approach is coming up. So this technology, the definition of technology and the shape and size of the technology is changing with the change in time. Then if you go through this particular unit, you will find out there's a course called head called e-commerce. So this e-commerce is basically electronic commerce, a commerce which was usually done by brick and mortar mode. Now it is replaced by electronic commerce. So electronic commerce was started with the help of websites and now taken a shape of a app-based commerce, which is now a mobile commerce or m-commerce. So this mobile commerce is quite agile, quite versatile in nature because it is with you, mobile is with you always, and any time at any pace you can do that. So this had given new shape and new way of doing the business. So now the consumer is traveling. At that time he can shop for a food, at the same time he can buy the commodity, and he can do multiple jobs with multiple pace. So m-commerce is there. Then franchising is a philosophy which is an old whiskey new bottle, and the old philosophy is there, but the concept is changing. The franchising philosophy is changing, and then logistics and supply chain business is there. In this commerce, e-commerce era, we have observed that logistics was basically something which was, you know, shifting goods from one place to one destination to other destinations, but with the help of supply chain business, with the help of supply chain management, it is not merely, you know, supplying the goods. It is how you're going to deliver the goods and what could be the tracking record, what could be the tracking time. And on the other hand, we have seen that the supply in this e-commerce era, the refund policy is going to play a very important role. The companies who are not able to provide an instant refund or not able to give the appropriate refund to their consumers, their business deteriorate, and people migrate from that portal to other portal. So keeping in mind this logistics and supply chain is a hot cake in the present scenario, and we have observed that how the logistics is going to do many things, not only delivering the goods but sometimes, you know, navigating the consumers, all those things are going to affect. And outsourcing and offshoring is very important, because when you are expanding yourself in other country or in other jurisdictions, or sometimes, you know, when, or your more number of footfall is coming up, in that case you have labor constraint or due to, you know, employee constraint, you have to outsource your business to other third party. If you see this emerging trends in business, this what I was talking about, that automation, blockchain, AI, machine learning, social shopping, robotics, e-tailing, and retail entrepreneurship is coming up. E-tailing is nothing but a electronic retailing where retail is purely going to be organized in the coming years, and those who are unorganized, those segment which is unorganized, still it is going to be organized. So this trend is coming up, and you will see that when the retail is going to be organized, this sector can go up in a more fruitful manner. Robotics and automation is something which is there. It's automation is not in just, you know, giving external shape to the product. Automation is making a conducive environment, making a customer friendly approach. If you talk about, you know, the Industry 4.0 purely believes in industry automation. And this Industry 4.0 is a is a new kind of auto revolution, which says that that we have to come out from this conventional way of fuel cars. We have to go for this we can say electric cars or chauffeurless cars. So this automation believes in purely internet cars, and we are moving in this direction. We have moved from this blended approach to hybrid approach, where hybrid age is coming up, where automatically there is no need of fuels, and automatically the car can charged, and with the help of charging, with the help of lithium polymer batteries, they can perform. So blockchain is something which is going to play a very important role, and we have seen that how the blockchain was, which was just a model for regulating the virtual currencies. Now it had been changed, and this blockchain is helping in electronic learning also. So what I mean to say, the basic ingredient behind business is not just buying or selling or just imposing or floating product to the consumers. You have to navigate the consumers. You have to educate the consumers. So making consumers aware about the product, aware about the technology, and how you're going to make that. No doubt, the technology is going to play a very important role. There are certain products which we are doing quite well, but right now they are evaporating from this scenario. And this machine learning and artificial intelligence is doing a good job in this circumstances. In the pandemic scenario, we have seen that in the lockdowns, the robots' roles are quite playing a very important role. And this robotics is not confined to the scientific industries, but it is facilitating or navigating the consumers. There were some stores which is human free, and we have observed that these stores are equipped with the wallets, and the products are in the store, and no human beings are monitoring that. The individual enters the store, swipe the with the machine the payment part, and then take a product. So everything is managed by the robots. So this is the thing which is there, and retail entrepreneurship is coming up. So social shopping is coming up, where the example of the community kitchen and other thing is there, where the mega kitchen is going to be developed, and certain issues like hygiene and other things are taken care, and packaging and delivering the product and logistics, how the things are going, because there are certain things which are going on at some of the places in a quite well manner, like the Dibbawala example in Bombay. But again, if these Dibbawala or these stereotype players can equip themselves with the technology, they can do the wonders. So that need to take in care. It's not rather that introducing new kind of technology every time and talking more about the technology, but it's like that whatever the existing technology we have, whatever the existing model we have, we try to impose technology and make it a win-win kind of thing. So this is the thing which is there, and there's impact of technology on business. We have seen that customers are also changing with the change of time, and employers are also changing, employees are also changing. So there is a holistic way of change is there. But what I have talked in the very beginning, that every time you can't talk about the change. If you talk about the change always, what will happen? That you always talking and implementing the change, but you're not going to get the benefit of change which need to be done at that juncture. So change should be gradual in nature. It should be done in a systematic manner, and you have to see what proportion of change should be there, and when you have to apply the change. It's not like that you can have a big bang approach and done everything at one shot. So vanilla approach need to be taken care, where you have to be gradually follow the process and do the things in a routine manner. So there are certain advantages and disadvantages of e-commerce, which I was talking about, that when you more talk about the e-commerce, a country like India, which is heavy populated and not digitally equipped at all the places, their e-commerce is not applicable in a full-fledged manner. But so you have to follow a process where the blended model is there. That is the reason Amazon have also realized that every time you can't talk about e-commerce and you know the cloud computing or the contemporary buying and selling, you have to follow a blended approach. So that is the reason they have bought a stereotype or you know the brick and mortar stores, so they can cater both the segment. So that is more important, you know, rather than making a product for the particular class and creed, it's always better that you make a product which can reach to the unreached. So that is the thing which is there, and wallets and plastic money is one of the important ingredients of m-commerce. App is no doubt is shifting from conventional website to other things, but lot of more thing is coming up. Virtual currency is coming up. Facebook is coming up with their own wallet called Libra, and this the moment they have launched this product, the virtual currency, the venture capitalists who have invested in Facebook, they were annoyed. So the intention was very clear: when virtual currency is going to come, what will happen that the whole financial system is going to become haphazard, and the different kind of threat is also going to happen. So we have to always not see the good parts. We have to see the disadvantages of anything. When any new things come up, it comes with certain you know obstacles, certain stumbling blocks. So that stumbling blocks need to be taken care, and if you come out from that stumbling blocks, the things can go on. And we have observed that in startups also, the people have a feeling, always have a good feeling. Though the first generation entrepreneurs, they are very enthusiastic in the beginning stage, but finally when they develop the product, when they come into the market, they realize that the life is not a bed of roses, and they have to struggle a lot. And what happened that there's a very famous quotation in the German philosopher has said that if tragedy is not going to kill you, it will make you strong. So when the thing gets tough, the tough gets going. So what had happened that these players you know thinks that the things would be good, but actually when they come into the market, lot of financial crunch is there, and when you are an entrepreneur, you have not have to take care about your bread and butter, but the other's bread and butter. So this kind of issue comes, and finally what happened that their system become haphazard, and out of this 100 startups, only 10 or 5 get the success, and remaining 90 you know wash out, and nobody knows. And the venture capitalists who had invested, the crowd funder, the angel investors, they are very embarrassed. And finally what had happened that their morale you know goes down, and those who are the real startups and those who are the real you know desire of these money, they won't get that opportunity. So what I was talking in the very beginning, that the title was emerging opportunity in business, that opportunity we have to grab. And as a entrepreneur, as a technocrats, as a startup, you know, the intention should be always very clear. If you have got a malified intention at the day one, so you won't get a success. And the intention behind that, you should always, you know, think positive. And in business also, we always believe that business is a going concern. So if you always follow this modus operandi, so the chances of success is very high. Because if you cheat a customer, there is a very famous quotation which says that first time you make me fool, shame on you. Second time you make me fool, shame on me. So if you are making consumer a fool, ultimately what will happen that the consumer will make you evaporate from the whole scenario. And there were some good examples, some bad examples. We have seen that there are good companies who have got a very good intention in the beginning stage, but they are not taking care of their consumers in a positive manner. So what had happened? They are on the deathbeds. And the companies who are always thinking about their consumers, you know, thinking about the refund policy, like providing sales, providing after sales services, and you know, giving better services for a longer time for the committed period, they no doubt you know add certain benefited. They are benefited, and finally, end of the day, the company is going to be benefited by that. So, lot of change is coming up, and the modus operandi is also changing with the change of time. And when we are talking about the franchise business is also changing. There was a time when the company used to keep a lot of royalty for for giving the franchises, but right now they are also quite liberal. So they know that if the other country counterpart can provide a good services, no doubt the customers are benefited, and we can you know earn with the turnovers, not on the profit margin. So turnover is something, you know, rotation is going to play a very important role, and their franchising is something which is very important. Outsourcing and offshoring is changing with the change of time. We have seen that outsourcing, when required, the work is done overseas, and offshoring is basically the work is done overseas, and outsourcing is someone else does the work for us. So we have seen that when there is a demand of work generated in particular jurisdiction, and due to labor crunch, due to shortage of manpower, they allocate this job to third party. So this outsourcing come up. Indian IT industry is purely depend on outsourcing business, and lot of what I was talked about, the Narayan Murthy, that started with the Y2K issues, purely outsourcing work which was not catered by these American companies, IT companies, and they have done it. And at the later stage, they have created a product, they have come up with their own, you know, softwares, they have tied up with all the big companies like SAP or the ERP softwares, and developed their own customized indigenous softwares, which is not, you know, serving their organization, but the other organizations also. So this is a trend which is going on. Logistics and supply chain business is also changing with the change of time. And supply chain is something which I was talking about, that logistics was something which we started, it was started with the supplier and end to consumers. Whereas if you see in the beginning stage, logistics was, when we talk about the logistics, it is nothing but, you know, a stereotype distribution channels, like starting from manufacturer and end to consumers. But right now a lot of follow-ups playing a very important role, and these follow-ups are nothing but the how the refund policy is going to matter when the product delivered to the consumers, whether they are satisfied with the product. If they are not satisfied, what are the, you know, reasons behind that. So lot of, you know, the chains are there, which is, you know, maintained by the suppliers and managed by their counterparts. So in logistics also, in the coming years, we have seen the tracking records. So when the product was delivered couriered from the manufacturers, you can, with the help of tracking records, you can able to see that how the product is going on. So when the product delivered, whether it was in good condition or bad condition, so these kind of thing is there. And refund policy is something which is an important ingredient. Those companies who not believe in refund policy, their market deteriorated, and when the consumer embraced with their particular product and they are not able to, you know, get their money back or, you know, get the product refunded, they give a very negative comment, and these negative comment work as a mouth marketing, and finally what happened, the company image deteriorate, and finally they are out from the picture. So this is a thing which is there, and there are certain global business management trends like rapid innovation continues. Already I have talked a lot. So I think the session which was started with the emerging opportunities, and the definition of opportunities also changes with the change of time, and the technology is something which definitely work as a feather in a cap, and change of technology is also changing with the change of time. So and what could be the parameter of, you know, inclusion of technology that need to be taken care, and gradually, you know, the things are going to be changed, and the data and analytics and big data analytics and how the consumer, you know, approach is changing with the change of time. So this is the trend which is going on. So definitely this particular course can provide you some more depthness once you go through the text. And on the other hand, this video can definitely, you know, work as a teaser, and it can help you when you require. But on the other hand, we request our learners to go through this particular text and try to correlate with the current trends. and more, you know, supplements are there which could be available on the website, on the search engine. So that can definitely add your learnings. Thank you very much.